Hello everybody, I'm Twonky the Chicken and you're not watching Nomadicraft today. This is the first part of my humble indie bundle playthrough. I'll be showing off a few of the games that you get in the bundle, both bundle 2 and 3, as I did pay over the average to get the second bundle. So the first game we're going for is a game by the name of And Yet It Moves. On first impressions, it's not looking like the best start. It hasn't got a title, but, you know, don't judge a book by its cover. The art style in this game is interesting. Yeah, it's interesting, that's how I'll say it. So I'm just going to go to start game and see what happens. I may have to possibly turn the graphics down depending on whether or not it lags. But yeah, the art style is awesome. I mean, it's pretty basic, but what I really like is the fact that this paper's not just in the background and the main playing level, it's in the foreground as well, which is, it's a interesting addition. This is one thing I do like about indie games. You don't get as many, you get interesting art styles that you really wouldn't see in mainstream AAA titles. As you may have noticed, I'm not great at this game. I die constantly from stupid things. Well, that's level one finished without much trouble. That is only died once. It's a good start. Right. What I do like is if you die in these holes, it's like you're falling down, but you're playing. So it's weird. I like it. It's great. And I'm dead again. I'd get used to me dying. It's a common occurrence. Run. Yeah, skills. Pro elite skills. The physics is interesting in this game because the momentum kind of carries. So if I just stood here turning it constantly and kept falling, the momentum would speed up eventually and I'd die if I hit the floor, which I'm not going to do because I'll just make myself dizzy. As you can see there, it doesn't just stop me when I turn it sideways, the momentum continues, which I really like. And that adds a new difficulty factor into the game, really, which gives it that extra bit of depth. It's quite a simple game, and I'm not sure if there's a storyline or anything to this, but it's a simple game, but it's got some interesting ideas. See, as you can see there, I jumped and rotated it and I carried on jumping even though I'd rotated it, which I do like it. I don't think I could play this for ages, but it's a nice little time waster of a game. I'm dead again. It's a nice time waster. Jump and think I've done. Yeah, level 2. Come on. I'll probably make this video about like. And it's lagging again for some reason. Nope, it's okay now. It's okay now. Right. Make me land on a downward slope if you want me to survive. I would if I wasn't lagging like a bitch. I'm just going to turn the graphics down. Just set it to low, it should be alright. Or maybe not. Be right back. I'm not sure what was happening there. It just started lagging for no reason. How do I get up here? Oh, there, I can turn the screen colour. Yep, I just forgot the fundamentals of the game. And it doesn't seem to have turned out. Oh. Didn't do anything. Okay. Many, many options there. The controls are really simple, really easy, just like typical platform controls really. W, S, A and D movement and up, down, left and right to rotate the screen. Really simple, nothing difficult to get grasp, to get used to. Yeah, it's just typical platformer controls, as this is a pretty typical kind of platformer. Not sure what this is here. Ah, it collapses. Okay. That's nice to know. And I'm dead again. Obviously. And it seems that they don't respawn, which I do like. That is good. I like that a lot, yes. Very good. Ah! 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 No! No! Spawn killed. I'm dead again. Drop down to that to slow my momentum and I'm dead. Drop onto that, slow my momentum, and it didn't slow my momentum. Forward, drop onto that, drop down. I'm dead. Okay, go this way then. Forward. Forward. Ow! This game's actually kind of difficult. It's got an interesting challenge to it anyway. I certainly wasn't expecting it to be difficult. Oh! I'll try and finish this level and then I'll leave the video at that. Across there. There we go. You can't step on that. It's not easy to figure out which direction you actually have to go. It's kind of linear, but it's not like... Ow. Crushed. Oh, well, I got it out of the way, didn't I? Just drop down there. Turn one. Jump! Hoo-hoo-hoo! That was a close one. And that was a bit... No! And there's the finish line. But I don't know how to go down. Do I need a brick to knock that off? I'm guessing so. Ah, there we go. I'm guessing you need a brick to knock that off then. And that's that. And that is, and yet it moves. It's an interesting. Are they enemies? Oh, it looks like it. Anyway, it's an interesting platformer. It's got interesting physics, interesting art style. I would definitely recommend it if you want to kill a bit of time. I don't think it'd keep me interested for ages, but it's good looking. It's very good looking. So yeah. On to game number two.